The life of a professional triathlete consists of many different things. It's not like being a ball player or something where you're part of a team and you have a ton of coaches and managers. You have to manage your own time, and I also have to be very proactive, both in terms of my training, my health. I have a lot of people around me that sort of contribute and help me out in different ways, but I need to sort of be hands-on with most of the things myself. Being part of the Danish national triathlon team, we also have access to facilities at the House of Sports here in Copenhagen. And I try to make use of that whenever I can when I'm in Denmark, because it's a good opportunity to do things right and to make sure that my body is working and that everything is on track. We have some excellent strength training facilities there. We have a sports doctor, we have physios, we have personal trainers there that can help us out with programs or specific exercises. I've had some trouble with my right knee for a while, that I've just been feeling some discomfort, slight pain around this area. And I had it scanned now a month ago, and I realized that there was something's called a jumper's knee, or a malfunction of the patella tendon down here.
You can see this area here, this normal tendon, and here we have a problem which we are treating.
What they tell us to do about the kind of stuff these days is to do heavy load strength training, very controlled. So I have to go both up and down very, very slowly. But with quite a lot of weight. I never thought I would be doing strength training with this kind of weights, but it's quite fun, it's something different. The injury is in a phase now that I can still train quite a lot. I'm not doing as much as I would like to, but I can still do a fair bit. And with this type of injury, it takes months and months to get much better. So it's much a matter of trying to just contain it the way it is and making sure that it's not getting worse. We have a really good training group in Farum at our National Training Center. We're generally a group of 10 people or so that bike and run together. But always there's somebody to train with, because I think it brings a lot of joy into it, especially if you're a social person, which I generally am. I try to always use my training as my space, so to speak. That's where I can just be myself out there on the roads, and I really try to enjoy that. I think a lot of people, they tend to always wish they were somewhere else. When I'm training, I enjoy being there, and rather than thinking that I'm currently missing out on something with my family. And when I'm with my family, I enjoy that and try to keep my mind off other things that might need to be done later on, some business stuff or whatever. Just always try to enjoy and be present at what you're doing. Now that I'm 35, I doubt that I would be doing any better as an athlete than I have been if I didn't have the family, because I'm pretty sure that I would be unhappy in another way.
When you have kids, you can't just go ahead and do your own thing like you used to do. You have to make other priorities. So we find a good balance of getting training, kids, and also time to be just Rasmus and I.
I sincerely enjoy it when we get to have time together. That's something that regenerates me as well and gives me energy for those tough training hours that I put in there as well. Training frequently becomes a priority over the family. It's necessary. It's the same thing as most people go to work every morning, although they might prefer to spend some time with their family. This is my work. What makes it complicated is that a lot of the time my training is quite free. I can do it a little bit earlier, a little bit later, the way I want to, and sometimes just the fact that you have this opportunity makes it more difficult to go away. It makes it tough. it's difficult being a father and a husband with an unhappy family at home. It's not nice. But sometimes I just have to put on that real professional act.
I think he's found a good balance, and he'll leave 2 weeks before Hawaii, and I know these 2 weeks he'll go into his zone, and I'm happy I'm not there, because there's not much space for anyone else than Rasmus in this zone, and that's what it takes.
Once you get to Kona, it's not much about training to become any better on race day. It's more about freshening up, getting ready, just give your body enough stimuli to keep responding and keep performing. But you don't want to try and do any panic training and try to make up for any lost mileage you've missed throughout the season. It's just a matter of keeping your body going and getting ready, really. I'm ready to finish this project off. It's been a long year, but I also feel that I'm in a good place now. I feel ready for the race. I feel hungry about racing. I certainly want to perform well here. It's been a dream all through my triathlon career. Who knows, next year maybe I'll have another goal in another race that I want to race really well in, but for now it's going to be counts. Didn't really go as I hoped it to go. I did all the right things. I think I prepared really well, but my body just didn't respond the way I would have liked to on race day. In a situation like that, it's just a matter of getting back on the horse and trying to set new goals and prepare well and get motivated for next season. Until then, I'm going to try and make up for some lost time with my family and go and spend some quality time with them now.